and giving your very valuable time this morning, Mataji, and eagerly waiting for your class. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Mataji, Dhanvat Pranam, so glories to Srila Prabhupada, the glories to Guru Maharajas and all the assembled Vaishnavas. This is Kirtida Sundari Dasi.
Hare Krishna, Kirtida Sundari Mataji, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj. Thank you so much, Mataji, for joining the call and giving your very sweet association this morning, Mataji. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, are there any devotees on the call who would like to introduce themselves? Okay. Hare Krishna, I welcome all the devotees to our Bhakti Sangha Japa conference call of our Janmashtami special Krishna Katha Mela. And as part of this session, today we are very fortunate to have with us Her Grace Padma Sakhi Mataji to enlighten on the topic of Akrura visits Vrindavan. Hare Krishna, Padma Sakhi Mataji, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj. Thank you so much, Mataji, for joining this call and giving your very precious time and association this morning, Mataji. Before handing the call, Mataji, I would like to give a brief introduction. So just give me a minute, Mataji.
Shama Supriya Mataji, let me and Preeti Vilasni get this honor of introducing you all coordinators.
Yeah, sure, Mataji.
So please, we both will take care of that because we all want to honor all of you with all your wonderful services. So today we are really fortunate. Can I request everybody to be on mute? Yeah, thank you. So today we are really very, very fortunate to have Her Grace Padma Sakhi Mataji with us. And before... Hare Krishna. Yeah. So before we move forward and hand over the call to her, I would just like to give a brief introduction for Padma Sakhi Mataji. And we all know her. She is the part of our Bhakti Sangha coordinator team. But just a formal, you know, intro I want to give about her. She came into Krishna consciousness in 2010 through her husband, His Grace Nayanabhiram Prabhu. And she was initiated by His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj in 2013. Her husband has been preaching in University of Cincinnati for the past 7 years, and Mataji also assists him in his preaching. She also conducts children classes at Tampa, Florida, and Mataji is very fondly known for her craft classes and the rhymes that she has composed herself with her sweet, melodious voice. She is a regular teacher in our Bhakti Sangha Japa group for the Govinda kids. And she has also volunteered sometimes to give sessions for the Damodar kids. Her summer craft classes have always been fun for the kids, and her Parikrama classes for Vrindavan Parikrama and Mayapur Parikrama for the adults during the month of Kartik was a great hit. And we are really grateful to have her as a part of team. She is very sweet at heart, very reciprocative, and she really knows how to be grateful too. So we are really very fortunate to have Her Grace Padma Sakhi Mataji with us. So Mataji, please, you can take over. And we are really eagerly waiting to hear from you. Hare Krishna. You are on mute, Mataji. We can't hear you.
Sorry, I'm on mute device. Thank you so much. I don't deserve to get introduction from you, Mataji. Thank you so much. Whatever is there, it's all because of prayers like all the devotees like all of you. Okay, thank you. And I will start. I'm on two devices. So one is the audio and one is the video. I have some problem with the laptop. So we'll start prayers. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयं मुदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेषु अबद्धेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपाकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः नमः पंकजनाभाय नमः पंकजमालिने नमः पंकजनेत्राय नमस्ते पंकजांग्रे नमः ओम विष्णुपाद ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनाशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते राधानाथ स्वामीनिति नामिने नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामीनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौर वाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे Thank you so much. Please pray that I'll be able to present talk properly about the topic today. I seek all of your blessings. So today we will be seeing Akrura visiting Vrindavan and taking Krishna. So that will be our discussion for the next 1 hour. So we might be thinking just... I was just thinking, many times we hear that Krishna likes Vrindavan, Krishna never steps out of Vrindavan. So then what is the point of, you know, why are we discussing about Krishna being taken away? Because it's little painful, it's little disturbing to know that he's been taken away from Vrindavan. So why we discuss is, one is we will then realize the glories of Vrindavan, and also we will realize the glories, how grateful the residents of Vrindavan are. We know this pastime where Krishna is in Dwaraka. So Dwaraka is very, very opulent, and the queens, they were serving him so nicely. There is no complaint on any regarding anything. But still Krishna used to cry. Thinking about gopis, his pillow would get wet. So then the queens would be thinking, what is that we are not doing, that, you know, Krishna wants, Krishna is always, you know, saying Radha, is thinking about gopis. So they were all getting confused. Then there was so much, they were very inquisitive. Like, who are they? Who are these gopis? What is special about them? So even if in our case also, if we have anything precious, and when we have to give it or we lose it. Like one time what happened, I lost my bead bag when I was in, it was my initiated bead bag. I went to, during my treatment, I was there in the hospital for 6-7 hours. So miraculously, I was chanting. I don't know how I lost it, but I lost it. I came home and I realized that I lost it. And 3-4 days I was going every day, you know, checking all the dustbins. There was no place that I didn't check. I checked everywhere and they were all cooperating very nicely. But I couldn't find it. And it was very surprising because it's a bag. It's not that, unless and until somebody wantedly takes it away, it's not that I will lose it, right? So I used to cry. And then they would ask, like, why are you crying? It is just a bag you're saying. Then I would tell them how glorious it is, how important it is. Then they will all understand. It's been 3 years. But even now when I go, still I have a hope. So at the front desk, I will still ask, did you find any green bag like that? So when something is dear and when we lose it, and then the others also, like the hospital nurses, they all came to know about what is this chanting, how is it very special. So like that, now Krishna likes Vrindavan a lot. And when he's taken away from that, that is when the glories, more glories are revealed. So that is one reason. And that's the reason, if you see Akrura visiting Vrindavan is almost 3.5 chapters. It is discussed 38, 39, 40 and 36. A little bit is mentioned where Kamsa is asking Akrura to bring Krishna. He mentions that in 36th chapter of 10th canto. So now that's the beginning of Krishna being taken away from Vrindavan. And so, as we all know, Aritsasura is a demon. When the demon was killed, that is when Radha Kund, Shyam Kund will appear. And that time, what was happening in Mathura was Narada Muni, he goes there. And till then, Narada Muni, Kamsa didn't know, like Krishna is the eighth child of Devaki. He didn't know that Vasudev took him all the way to Nandagaon. I mean, Gokul. He didn't know that. Now, Narada Muni comes and Narada Muni thinks that now it's been more than a decade, because I think Krishna is a little more than 10 and a half years, a little more than 10 and a half when he visited Mathura. So, he will be like, it's more than a decade. Now he has two different pastimes. There's a different purpose of why Krishna, Krishna came to the earth planet. So, he will go. And he will start spilling the beans. He will say, the eighth son is Krishna and Vasudev took him in the middle of the night. And he will say all the story. Then Kamsa is like, oh, they did a big natak and then they didn't tell all this. I was trusting Vasudev and Devaki. Now I have to go and do some punishment. Then Narada Muni will say, no, you first take care of Krishna, because if something happens to them, then Krishna might come and then he might fight with you. So instead of that, first take care of Krishna, and Balaram is also their son. So take care of them and then you can see what you can do with them. So many times we will see that, even in movies, they portray Narada Muni as a cunning or as funny character. But we know Narada Muni is a great devotee, and whatever the devotee of the Lord does is always in sync with the desires of the Lord. So whatever Lord wants to do is only Narada Muni is doing, because great devotees are always in sync. Whatever Lord thinks, they can understand and they act the same way. And when great personality does, see, sometimes when I want to do benefit to somebody, it might harm, the same act might harm somebody else. But when great personalities does, there is no harm. Like now, if you see in this case, Narada Muni spilled the beans. Now, what is going to happen? Krishna is going to come. When Krishna is going to come, he's favoring Devaki and Vasudev. Imagine they have just, the baby's just born, and then they had to give Krishna away. So it's such a pain for the parents, especially the mother. We are all mothers here. We can understand the pain. So now Devaki can see Krishna and Balaram, and Kamsa will be, the whole world will be now saved from demoniac king Kamsa, and Kamsa also will be benefited because he's being killed by Krishna. So it's a whichever side we see, everything is a beneficial aspect only. So that is how when the pure devotees do, they think they do benefit for everybody. Then that is happening in Mathura, and then he will send, now Kamsa will send for one last time Keshi and Vyomasura. They will come to Vrindavan. See, he's come, so many demons are killed, but still he sends again. And when he sends, that then Narada Muni comes to Vrindavan and he talks to Krishna, and he will say, now it's like, it's your time. I see your future pastimes are being revealed to me, that Dwaraka fort is being erected, you marrying Dwaraka queens, Mathura. So many pastimes I'm being revealed. I'm able to know, my Lord, when are you going to do all these pastimes? You're marrying 16,000 gopis, Kala Yavana pastime, everything. So now Lord says, okay, I will come like that. I will come. He'll say like that. And then meanwhile, Kamsa will say, I'm going to do Dhanur Yagya. So like now these days, cricket teams or any big sports, they have a huge arrangement. So he will say, arrange a huge arrangement. It should be festive mood so that Kamsa and like Krishna and Balaram will not get doubt, and then they'll just come and then we can just finish them off very quietly. So he will say, just call them. just arrange that way. And then he will say, we will arrange Kuvalaipidya, then there is Chanur, Mushtika, Shala, Toshala, Kuta, all of like, he'll make arrangement. If Kuvalaipidya is missing, Chanur, Mushtika. If he's missing, they. If they are missing, then I am there to finish them off. So and now he'll be thinking, how can I call them? Just like in Kurukshetra War, when we see, if Yudhishthira Maharaj says only, Ashwatthama is killed, then Dronacharya will believe because he's a very trustworthy person. So similarly, he was thinking, who is the trustworthy person here? Then Akrura. Akrura is a great devotee of the Lord, staying in with Kamsa here. So then he will call Akrura, and Akrura, he will request, like he will say, like, I am getting a lot of enemies now. I'm going to finish them off. So you just go and call Krishna and Balaram. Just bring them, saying that we'll have just a wrestling match like that. Then Akrura will warn Kamsa indirectly. He will say, we can plan so many things, but ultimately the destiny, the providence is only going to win. And then Kamsa will give a new chariot, and Akrura will feel so happy, not that he is going in the new chariot, because he was thinking it is not an etiquette to bring Krishna and Balaram in a chariot which Kamsa has used. But Kamsa, he already gives a new chariot for him to bring Krishna and Balaram. So now Akrura is very excited. There Kesi demon has gone. Then Krishna, we know how Krishna kills Kesi demon. And here Krishna's hand is like it's always compared as lotus eyes, lotus hand, lotus legs, because they're very soft, nice, pleasant, like that. But now when he keeps his hand in the Kesi demon's mouth, it is just like an iron rod, very hot iron rod. From this, we can understand that when the devotees are showing, like those who are showing worship and service attitude, his hands are like cooling soft moon. But if you're demoniac, the same hand is like a hot fire. So that is, now the Kesi is killed, Vyomasura is killed in the evening. During the evening time, Vyomasura is killed. And now, Narada Muni also came and he said, see, Narada Muni's other name is Deva Darshan. So Deva Darshan has three meanings. One is Deva, who can have the darshan of the Supreme Lord. One is, the other meaning is, if you see, if you have darshan of this personality, it is as good as seeing Deva, the Supreme Lord. And one is, the third meaning is, whose vision is transcendental. So Deva Darshan is Narada Muni. So he also came, he informed Krishna. Now our Akrura is getting ready. And Kamsa made his request. See, demoniac people, if they have to fulfill their desires, they do anything. They talk pleasing sometime. And when the work is done, they just say, who asked you to do? So they just keep changing their words. They have double tongues. So he is like now nicely talking to Akrura. Please bring. he said that. Like Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says one shloka. Dvau bhuta sarga lokes mindaiva asura eva cha vishnu bhakta smritu daiva asura stadvi parayaha. So he's saying two classes of men exist, demoniac. But why we have to learn about demoniac people? Because we will know what not to do, how should we not behave. And when we see devotees, we know about devotees, we will know what to aspire for. So that's why we should see about two, like both of them, demoniac people and devotees. So now Akrura, whole night, he didn't sleep. So many times we will go to Vrindavan Yatra, Vrindavan Yatra or any Yatra, any Holy Dham Yatra. So there should be many times the Acharyas stress what should be our mood when we are going to a Holy Dham. It's very, very important, because 2019 when I was going to Yatra, that summer I have gone to India in May, June, July, August I was in India, but some of my friends were going. Somehow devotees mercy, they were saying, and I got very inspired. I was asking my Prabhu if we can go, and he didn't get a leave in his office because he already got leave for summer. But somehow when we requested, they just accepted for a week. We were about to go. Then evening, I was on a flight around 7:30 from Fort Lauderdale. I went to bring my kids at 12 o'clock in the afternoon from school. As I was walking, my leg hit to a stone when I parked the car. And my two fingers of the leg, just literally, they got detached. I could feel they were waving from my leg. So they're like, oh my God, what happened now? What should I do? I informed my Prabhu. He said, go to urgent care. Then I went to urgent care and I was literally thinking, now I have a flight in the evening. If something happens, I will miss my yatra. What to do? Then I called some devotees. I think if I'm not wrong, I called Vinita Gandharvika Mataji also asking, please pray. Then the doctor said, yes, you have a fracture, but there is nothing we can do because it's fingers. So they just tied and then they said, you can just decide what you want to do. So, but we decided we will go. It was like actually a lot of pain. The blood got clotted. The next day morning, as soon as we land, was the yatra. I don't have any rest for my leg. I couldn't rest my leg. But the point I'm making is, we should have immense amount of devotees' mercy. It is not that you buy ticket and go somehow. And the first day I went, it was Madan Mohan Temple. My Prabhu bought a nice chappal for me so that it is nice and soft. I didn't want to walk with chappal, but with that condition, he insisted you have to walk with chappal. But the first place we went was Madan Mohan Temple and I lost my chappal. So whole yatra, we didn't get time to buy chappal also. And I was walking like that only. But it is absolutely because of the devotees' prayers and mercy, I could finish that yatra. So it is not that we buy a ticket and we will go. We need a lot of mercy. Though we are like now as Akrura, he's meditating whole night about Krishna. His pastimes, you know, Krishna, Balaram, like that he's been, his consciousness was Krishna consciousness, and that is the right mood. Because many times I see celebrities, sometimes, you know, somewhere some people keep sending, they do a lot of puja, this in a large pompous way. When there is Lakshmi puja, this Durga puja, because they have a lot of money, lot of fame, they do it in a large scale. But what do they do in puja? I see, you know, they keep talking, they'll be showing sari talking, or they will take selfies. So that is not the mood when the Lord is there. Before even I was like that, but when I came to Krishna consciousness, it made sense. So now Akrura's mood was so proper that he was thinking about Krishna and then entering. And he's like so anticipating, like, oh, I will see Mukunda's lotus face. And then he started, Sukadev Goswami describes very, very nicely. He says, Mamaita Durlabham Manya Uttama Shloka Darshanam Vishayatmano Yata Brahma Kirtanam Shudra Janmanaha. So he's saying, I'm a materialistic person. He's saying out of his humility, he's not a materialistic person. But he's saying, I'm a materialistic person, completely absorbed in sense gratification. So, Mataji, can you see me?
Video is frozen, Mataji.
Frozen, Mataji.
I don't know what happened, Mataji. Can you see? Yeah, I suppose. Should I keep talking? Maybe it will get better. Am I audible, right?
Yes, Mataji. We can hear you clearly.
No, it's saying it's connecting again. Oh, Mataji. Okay, I'll be talking anyways. If it gets frozen, I will log out there and I will start talking from my cell phone. Oh, I think it got frozen. Mataji, can you please spotlight the other? I logged out from there because I don't want to waste time. Okay, thank you. So then Akrura will be saying, I am Shudra, I am very fallen, I don't have any qualification to go to see the Lord's Uttama Shloka like face. Many times out of humility, the devotees will be thinking that they are not qualified, but we should not stop our service because we are not qualified. We should, because Krishna's mercy and the devotee's mercy is much, much greater than our qualification. For example, if you see the example of Kaliya, even Nagapatnis have asked the same thing. My Lord, even Lord Brahma, Lord Shiva, Lakshmi, they're all looking for your, you know, dust at your lotus feet and you never gave it. But, you know, Kaliya is not a very, he's not a devotee, but what is that they did that? What is that he did that you kept your lotus feet on his head? Then Krishna will say, I just did it for you. Because you are devotees, to make you happy, I did it. So always, that's why they say we should always be surrounded with the devotees, because devotees, because their mercy, we will get qualification. So then Akrura is thinking like that. Even Sudama was thinking, Sudama Pasya was like, what qualification do I have? Why did Krishna behave so nicely with me? So Sudama was also not understanding what he did. So Akrura now started. In the morning, he did his morning duties and he started to bring Krishna and Balaram. And as he started, he's thinking one important shloka. He says that Adhya is today phalam. All my sinful reactions are gone. And the fruit of, see, when we are born, there should be something, some fruit to be achieved. So he says, the fruit of my birth is being achieved today. So he says that. So what is that fruit? Is darshanam. Darshanam of my Lord Krishna and Balaram. So then he will, even Prahlad Maharaj scenario, if you see, Prahlad Maharaj also was thinking he's unqualified to go and stand in front of Narsimhadev out of his humility. We know how great devotee Prahlad Maharaj is, but he still thinks, but finally he thinks, for my spiritual benefit and to build my connection with Krishna, let me go and stand in front of the Lord, and he will start going. So just like there are so many rivers, we know, but the greatest and the biggest river to cross is the river of the time, which we cannot cross time and again time comes like twigs. The twigs will be floating in the ocean. They will come and join with another twig for some time. They'll stay together. Again, after some time, that twig will get floating away. Again, they will come and join with another twig or a leaf. Again, so like that, even our life is like that. Time is over, then we go to another family. Time is over, another birth, another birth, another birth. Only the devotee's mercy can bring us any qualification in our life. Krishna's mercy and devotee's mercy is very, very important. That is these slokas Akrura is stressing in the slokas that we have seen. And then he was thanking Kamsa. Why is he thanking Kamsa? Because though Kamsa is very demoniac, still Kamsa, because Kamsa chose Akrura, that was the reason why Akrura even started to Vrindavan. So many a times, you know, what we can learn is, we sometimes say, they're bad, they are good. Even in devotees, we try to judge, even in material. Unfortunately, we do that judging, but we should always be grateful, whether they are good people, bad people, anything we receive from others, we should be very grateful. That is what Akrura is stressing here, because Kamsa gave him a chance. And then he also says he saw a good omen, like a deer is passing on from his right side. If you see, in our Vedic culture, all these omens, like when the Duryodhana was born, they saw all bad omens like foxes howling. So they believe these omens. So even now, Akrura is saying, from my right side, a deer is going. So all auspiciousness is going to happen. He's thinking all these things in his mind. And he think, on the other hand, he's saying, if the words that we are talking are bereft of the glories of the Lord, then it is just decoration of the dead body. He mentions that in the following shlokas. It's very difficult to see all the shlokas, so just taking some points from few purports. So he says, Nama, Guna, Rupa, Leela. These four things we have to be always, you know, meditating. These four, Nama, Rupa, Guna, Leela of the Lord, we have to always meditate. And then now Akrura is saying, this is the place where my Krishna is walking. Lakshmi, Brahma, Shiva, all of them are waiting for this lotus feet, and here is walking in Vrindavan. So he's anticipating, he's thinking all those things. And why we many times compare about lotus is, lotus has three things. One is, it's very beautiful. One is, it's very soft and pure. That's why the Pankaja. Panka is mud, ja is birth. So one which is born from the muddy water, and but it is still very pure. So that's why we compare Krishna with lotus, because he's having like soft, beautiful, and is full pure, is very transcendental. And now he says, now Akrura is saying, our sinful reactions are gone, but when will they be gone? When we surrender completely. If we have that surrender, like many times surrendering means we think we are losers. In wars, if you see Hiroshima, Nagasaki war, or Germany and Russia war, the losers will surrender. So that means it's a negative thing, negative aspect surrender. But in bhakti, surrender is not losing, but it's gaining. When you surrender, you gain a lot. Like if you see Krishna, because the Pandavas were willing to do anything, like they completely surrendered, Krishna was willing to hold chappal of Draupadi. I see many times, you know, when we go to any devotee's house or anywhere, not only devotee's house, anywhere, it's an etiquette that we don't let others touch our chappal. I see that from childhood. So now but Krishna is touching the chappal of Draupadi. We know that past time where she was coming to see Bhishma, then Bhishma was doing his meditation, she did prayers, and she didn't want to disturb. So Krishna will hold the chappal and he will ask, you go inside, I will hold your chappal. So Krishna does all these, you know, the menial things for us. And Mirabai is so surrendered that, you know, she was willing to take poison also. So Krishna is always sold out to the surrendered souls. And now he will say, as soon as I see Krishna and Balaram, I'm going to do obeisances. And many times we have deities at home. Every day morning, I do obeisance in the morning before putting them to sleep while offering. Many times we do obeisances, but these obeisances could be just for the sake of doing. Now, but there is a lot of importance now Akrura is stressing on, because I remember one story where once there was one Mataji who takes care of her Laddu Gopal very nicely. And then she fell sick, so she handed it over to her daughter-in-law. And the daughter-in-law was taking care, but the Laddu Gopal fell from her hands one day. And then the mother-in-law was feeling something. She was not feeling good. She was not eating. Daughter-in-law didn't tell that the Laddu Gopal fell, but she was feeling something bad in her heart and she was not feeling good. She didn't feel like eating. Then the daughter-in-law was like, oh, she's not eating anything. Then she says, somehow I feel my Laddu Gopal is not doing good. I feel there's something wrong. Then she mentions that the Laddu Gopal slipped from her hand. And she says, no, then my Laddu Gopal is sick now. You have to call the doctor. You have to call the doctor. Then she will think, what doctor will see a deity? But she will say, no, 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 no. Like a child, she'll be, you know, adamant, like, you have to call the doctor. So then the doctor will come and the doctor will feel very silly. How do I treat a deity? She'll say, no, my deity is not a deity. He's there. Just, you know, treat him. Then when he keeps the stethoscope, as soon as he can hear the heartbeat, then this doctor will faint. He will think, then he will understand that the deity means it's not just a stone or not a deity, but it is, the deity has really, there is God in there. Recently, I have gone to a Farmington Hills temple and there was a calendar that was published. So in Farmington Hills temple, if you see, Krishna is like this and Radha Gopijana Vallabha is like this and Radharani is like this. So they're like this. Radharani is like this and Krishna is like this. But in one calendar picture, see, if the angle is changed, Krishna's angle also should change. Right? Krishna is like this, but Radharani is like this instead of bending like this. I can send the picture. I wish I have the calendar, but I have to go. So then the devotees were saying, I took permission if I can tell this to anybody. So that's why I'm saying. So they said that day there was an umbrella behind Radharani's umbrella. And maybe that was the reason, you know, that umbrella was so tight that she just tilted like this. I'll send the picture, then you will clearly understand. So the deities means the deities are really there. So from then on, when I look at my deities, I'm like, oh my God, since 10 years, I'm taking care, but I don't have that feeling that they're really there. So when we do obeisances, that means we are, and it is said that, I think in Nectar of Devotion, one obeisance that you do in front of Krishna is, you know, it is tons of times more than a lot of pious activities that we do. So he is now, Akrura, stressing the importance of offering obeisances. And he also says, not only Krishna, I will offer obeisances to Balaram. And I will also, after going to Balaram, I will do to other cowherd men. That means Akrura is showing how we have to respect even others, not just Krishna. We have to respect. Many times what happens is we focus so much on the rules, regulations, Krishna, and we many times ignore devotees. In the name of taking care of deities, Krishna, we many times see that with some devotees come at us, you know, they mention that problem when we talk. So you know, Akrura is so showing the importance of taking care of everybody, not Krishna, Balaram, and everybody around him. So now somehow he's all in these thoughts, like he's thinking about all these thoughts, and he's not even knowing how the chariot is going. It's going hither and thither, here, there. Finally, he came to Vrindavan and he could see the footprints of Krishna. We know how we can differentiate the footprints of Krishna, because Krishna has very different marks on his foot, right? There is an elephant god, there is a chanka, chakra, barley corn. So now it is not preserved, but those days the gopis, the cows, whoever are walking there, they would preserve Krishna's footprints. So Akura saw that, and immediately he started offering dandavat, like obeisances. And then he says, like, we talk a lot about Krishna's lotus feet. Krishna's lotus feet is the place where Yamuna, Ganga, Saraswati all are reciting. And Krishna's, the bottom part is pink, and the toenails are white, and the top part is blackish, shama color. That is the color of Krishna's lotus feet. And everybody, we know, whoever surrenders to his lotus feet will get liberated. So now he's meditating on the lotus feet. He's taking his blessings and he's rolling on the dust. So many times we say Vrindavan's dust, but when we go to Govardhan Parikrama, and there's a place called Raman Reti, they do this parikramas on the dust. I literally saw there like 200, 300 people just rolling on the dust. They do that. So then now there's this one more shloka where he says, Deham Britam Jnan Artho Hitva Dambam Biyam Sucham Sandesha Dyo Harer Linga Darshana Shravanadi Bihi. So what is he saying? The goal of the life is this ecstasy. What is that ecstasy? What Akrura is experiencing? So Akrura is not fear now. Devotees of Lord are not having any fear, because Akrura can fear, oh, maybe there are spies of Kamsa. Maybe they're seeing me so ecstatic, and maybe they will go and tell to Kamsa that, see, he's a great devotee of the Lord, and maybe Kamsa will attack my family. He doesn't have anything. He's not thinking of that. He's just thinking. He saw Krishna's lotus feet and he's just thinking about that. So devotees of the Lord are fearless. Our Srila Prabhupada is fearless. And recently I was seeing Prabhupada's disciple, Jayananda Prabhu. There was an article in Dandavat where he was getting a lot of lumps on his face and body, but still he was fearless. And he was making cart of the Jagannath Ratakat. He wanted to finish that and he didn't rush to the hospitals. He was like, it's okay. And Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj, if you see, like, he has this big lumps here. But how much fearless he was, and he was just laughing. And recently I got a chance to speak to one of his disciples, and she was saying that with one leg, when they were, because Maharaj, they removed Maharaj's leg and he had only one leg. And with that one leg, he was like dancing in ecstasy when the kirtan was going on, and he was like swirling like this, and the devotees were like, oh, maybe anytime he will fall down in that ecstasy. So when she was saying, he was getting goosebumps, no fear. So Akura is also exhibiting that fearlessness. And then now he's saying, this is the goal of the life. What Akrura experienced is should be the goal of the life. And what is that? He put all his fear and lamentation, and he put those aside, pride, fear, lamentation, and he's just absorbed in seeing, hearing, and describing and glorifying the Lord. So seeing actually makes a lot of difference. There is one story about Kararabai, she visits from Maharashtra. She visits Jagannath Puri and she fell in love with the Puri deity, like Puri, and she didn't want to leave that place. She stayed there. She built a house. She stayed, and she used to think, oh, every day morning they're waking up my Lord, but they're waking up very late, and you know, my Lord might be feeling very hungry, and she would make khichdi. And literally Jagannath would come from the altar and eat her khichdi. So one day there was one sannyasi or some devoted person just came, stayed with her. What she was doing was, as soon as she wakes up, she would just go into the kitchen and start making khichdi. But he said, this is not the way you have to do for the Lord. You have to take bath, clean kitchen, and then do. So she said, nobody taught me. Now that you have taught, I will start doing it. So next day, the Lord came every day, whatever time she's offering, he came the same time to have prashad. But she's not ready. The Lord saw her that she's busy in she was taking bath. The next time he came, she was busy in kitchen cleaning. So then Mangalarti, and then she made khichdi. Finally, she made khichdi and he was eating. But it was in middle. He was in middle, and then Mangalarti, he could hear that you know, the doors are being opened and the Mangalati is being, it's about to start. So he will just rush, leaving the Khichdi in between. And then the Pujari started doing Aarti. And he realized that with that little bit of Aarti light, when we do Aarti in the morning, that is some light which is coming out, right? So that he could see a lot of Khichdi is there in Jagannath's, around Jagannath's mouth. And he says, Lord, we just started Mangalati. When did you eat? And the Lord responds saying, what all has happened. So that much attachment she developed just by seeing the deity. And even Banke Bihari, if you see, every 10 seconds or 50 seconds, they will be closing a curtain. Curtain, close, open, close, open, close, open, they will do. Why? Because long, long ago, there was these from Rajasthan, the Rajputs and the queens had come having darshan, and then they fell in love with Banke Bihari, and then they were praying Banke Bihari. They fell just when they saw, they fell in love and they couldn't leave him and go. So they wanted Banke Bihari to come with him, and Banke Bihari left and went all the way to Rajasthan. And finally, anyways, he comes back later. That's another story. So they didn't want anybody to develop so much attachment to the deity. So they're scared again Banke Bihari might leave. So every 50 seconds, they will close the altar so that relationship is not established between the deity and out of love. Out of their love, they do that, closing curtains and opening. So seeing has a lot of importance. And hearing about Krishna. If you see hearing about Krishna, Rukmini just heard about Krishna. And even Sukadeva Goswami, after he came out of his mother's, after he came onto this earth planet, what did he do? He just started walking. He sat under a tree and he was meditating. And his father was worried, like he's not coming back home. So he comes up with a plan and he will send few people they will stand around Sukadeva Goswami where he's meditating. They will stand around him and they will start doing some work near the trees as if they're working, cutting some wood, and they will be talking about Krishna. And then Sukadeva Goswami hears, like, who is this personality? Then they will say, like, you know, Vyasadeva is the one who told us, you come, we will take you there. So then Sukadeva Goswami was thinking, oh, I ran from my father Vyasadeva and all this knowledge is there with my father. And then he will go just by hearing, he developed a lot of attachment to know more and more about that personality. And then he gets all the knowledge from Vyasadeva. So hearing is very important. Seeing is very important. And now he's meditating on the beautiful face of Krishna, how beautiful he is, how his cheeks are, how his mouth is. So he's meditating. So now if you see, Krishna is very beautiful, right? During the Kurukshetra war, actually Krishna was on this planet, if I'm not wrong, 125 years. And so he was around 89-90 during Kurukshetra war. But how he was just like a 16-year-old boy. And Bhishma, he will say in his glorification, he'll be glorifying Krishna that in the dust raising from the Kurukshetra war, the matted hair that Krishna has because of the dust and the war and everything. But still, Vishwapitama says he's just like Gaura color, like so golden, so much effulgent, is so beautiful. So, and even Gopis saying, Gopi give this Dina Parikshaye Nila Kuntalaye Varanuharanam Bibratavratam Ghanarajaswalam Dakshayan Mohor Manasinasmaran Vira Yachasi. So what are they saying? At the end of the day, you show your lotus face covered with dark locks of hair and thickly powdered with dust. So end of the day, they're saying you look like this, but they're saying they just wait to see him, and they're just saying you're so beautiful. So who can be beautiful with matted hair, dusty face? We always try to wash our face if you have to just even step out of our house. So Krishna is very beautiful and Akrura is meditating on that beautiful face. And now Krishna and Balaram came. Krishna Balaram came and then they hugged him. They took him to Nanda Maharaj's house. Then Nanda Maharaj welcomed him so nicely, that olden day tradition, like washing legs, offering garlands, giving gifts, giving cows, then giving cows, you know, milk, feeding them nicely. Then they will discuss. Krishna inquires how everybody is in Mathura, and Krishna and Akrura tells what Kamsa is planning. Then Krishna and Balaram will laugh hearing the plot. Who can harm Krishna and Balaram? So they will laugh, and then he will say that you have to come. Then Nanda Maharaj also agrees, because they just think we'll go and then come back. So Nanda Maharaj will say to all the cowherd men, like, you just bring all gifts. What will be the gifts that they can give? This milk, milk sweets, ghee, butter, yogurt. So he'll say, pack everything. Tomorrow morning we will go because the king wants to see us. We'll just go, drop all the gifts and we'll come back. So now all these discussions are going on but now who comes to know? Gopis. Gopis are very sad. You know, gopis, they cannot even, they just can't even, there's a term, they say why they have to blink the eyes, right? They don't even want to blink the eyes because that fraction of second also, they don't want to miss not seeing Krishna. And if you imagine now what pain they have, their faces became pale and they were in so distress. They were so sad. They were like, what misfortune do we have? You know, now the Mathura Vasis are so fortunate that they will have they can see Krishna. Now, what did we do? How can we survive without Krishna? So they're very sad and they will be thinking, Akrura is like Akrura, but he's behaving Krura, like he's taking away Krishna from us. How can this happen? So they're very sad. They're very distressed. But now the things, and they think the elder people are not talking on behalf of us. They all decided that they have to go. Now we should only do something. Now they will come up with a plan. And now Krishna, Akrura, they're going on the chariot. Then Nanda Maharaj, all the Rajavasis are ready to go along, follow the chariot of Akrura. Then these gopis are in small groups. One group first comes and then stops. Then somehow they will be pacified and they will be sent. Another group. So they kept on coming, all different groups of gopis, to stop Krishna. But it was not possible for them to stop Krishna. And then they were very sad and they were looking at the chariot till, you know, sometimes when we go in the car, kids keep seeing, right? My kids, when they go to school, they keep looking all the way till they not see me. They will just see and then they'll close the window. So like that, till the dust raised and when it stopped, like they cannot see, there's no more vision of Krishna and his chariot, then they couldn't do anything. They were very sad. Now Krishna left. And actually when the gopis were coming in groups, if you see Vrindavan Parikrama also, we have seen different villages, they are named after, like suppose Krishna says, I'll come Parsa, day after. You please go, I'll come day after tomorrow. Then that village named as Parsa. And he will say, Shigra, I will come fast. So there's one village named as C, just C. Sigra has gone and became C. So like that, various places are described on the terminology that Krishna has used, like day after tomorrow, I will come. And when he was going, Puchri Kalota Baba, if you see on Govardhan, very, very beautiful, one of my favorite place, very beautiful place, Lota Baba. This Lota Baba was making prasad for Krishna and Balaram, and he saw the cart going and he's like, hey Krishna, hey Balaram, where are you going? I made prasadam for you. And Krishna will say, I will come and eat. And Lota Baba says, I am waiting for you. I will not eat. I will wait till you come. And they say that even till date, Lota Baba is waiting there. We have been to that place very recently also. And they were describing the story that Lota Baba is still there waiting with it. And if you wait without eating, you should be very thin. But if you see, Lota Baba is very fluffy, chubby, like, you know, Madhu Mangal. And His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj explained in one of his lectures that faith is the nourishment for him because he has faith. When Krishna said he's going to come, he's waiting with faith that Krishna is going to come. With that nourishment, he's still nice, healthy. So we all should have that faith. Now, now they started going. Now they're leaving Vrindavan. So apparently the border of Vrindavan and Mathura is Akrur Ghat. So there's a place once you reach Akrur Ghat, that means you are entering Mathura. So now at Akrur Ghat, there is Yamuna. So Akrura will stop the chariot so that Krishna Balaram will relax and rest for some time there. And they're resting and then Akrura goes, first Krishna Balaram will go. He will just drink some water. They will freshen up. And with their permission, Akrura will come. And Akrura will have a vision of Krishna and Balaram in the Yamuna, and he was like, they just went, how could this be possible? And he will be looking at the chariot, and when he looks at the chariot, he will see Balaram as Ananta Sesh, white complexion, blue dress, and Krishna like Vishnu, just relaxing, like he's showing his Vishnu form. And Akrura gets like, he's like, so imagine, like suddenly we see that kind of situation. He gets like so, and he sees all the demigods around Krishna and Balaram, Lord, all the demigods are gathered and they started offering prayers. So now Akrura is like, Akrura also offered wonderful prayers, glorifying Krishna, his incarnations. And once that vision is lost, he stopped his prayers. And then he will go to, after the vision is done, then he will go to Krishna and Balaram sitting on the chariot. Then Krishna will ask in a sarcastic way, Akrura, looks like you have seen something very surprising. No, I can see your face and recognize. What did you see? So in a riddle, like a sarcastic and funny way, he will ask. So Akrura also will be answering in a funny way, saying that, my lord, whatever I see is resting in you only. So anything I see, everything I see, whomever I see, everything is resting in you. So when I see you, what is that I have not seen? What is that is remaining that I have not seen? Everything is in you. So I'm seeing, as you said, yes, I have seen so everything because you are standing in front of me. So like that, the discussion will be going. And Akrur Ghat has a very nice significance because this is the place where Akrur Ghat is the place where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also stayed 500 years back. He used to have come here for lunch prasadam. So he used to have here. And one time, because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gets so ecstatic remembering about Krishna, Yamuna, blackish Yamuna, when he sees anything black, he gets so ecstatic. So he jumped in this Yamuna river. And then Balabhadra Bhattacharya, who was with the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he got like so scared. He just jumped and brought him outside. And then he decided, oh, maybe next time. He said, like, I don't want to stay here because today I am there and I have seen Mahaprabhu jumping. Tomorrow when he goes in ecstasy and when there is nobody around, then who will take care of him? So he says, we will leave this place, and nicely explains to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and they will leave that place. And the first significance is Akrura getting the vision of Anantasesh and Vishnu. Second significance is the Vrijavasis, one time after this, Nanda Maharaj is arrested and goes to Varuna Loka. When he goes there, if you remember, we're not going to that pastime, but Nanda Maharaj gets so surprised. My son is a little boy and Varuna is, you know, offering so much opulent prayers, opulent worship. And when he goes down, he will tell it to all the Vrajavasis, like, you know, Varuna Loka is so great, this opulent, that opulent. And he was offering respects to our little Kana, then all the Vrajavasis will be like awestruck. Oh, maybe it's very opulent. And Krishna wanted to show the place they are staying is much, there is no opulent place other than Vrindavan. He wanted to show that to them. So they will come here and then Krishna will give a vision of Vaikuntha, then Vrindavan, then all the Vrajavasis will see that this is the place that there's like how they see in a 70mm stream, like that they're able to see. And then, oh, this is the place, same place that we are staying. Same place. Then they understood that the place they are staying is not an ordinary place. Then they realized the glory of Vrindavan, how opulent Vrindavan is. So they got the darshan of Vishnu Loka and the spiritual Goloka here at Akrur Ghat. And one time also, there was a rumor spreading during Chaitanya Mahaprabhu time that Krishna has appeared again. Krishna took birth again. Only in the night time, they see Kaliya. Krishna's dancing on the Kaliya at here on the Akrur Ghat. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will say, what kind of rumor is this? I don't think that is true. Then the next minute, somebody who spread the rumor, they only came and said it was our fault. Actually, it was nighttime. The fisherman was fishing and then he has that jali, that net, and he has some lights in his hands. So somehow that they see the jali and they thought it is Kaliya snake, and seeing the fisherman, they misunderstood that it was Krishna. So it was our misunderstanding. So that pastime also, all that misunderstanding pastime also happened here at Akrur Ghat. Now Krishna is leaving. Now he's entering Mathura, and after he enters Mathura, that is the place where Akrura is requesting, can you please come with me to my home? Then Krishna says that I will come, but the main important thing I have is I want to first go and see the wrestling match, wrestling arena. I have to go see that first. I'll finish off that and then I will come and visit you. And Krishna fulfilled the desire of Akrura. Later, he went and visited his house. Now, Akrura played a major role in the transition of bringing Krishna from Vrindavan to Mathura. So I would like to end it here. I'm sorry if I spoke anything wrong, or please do any corrections or comments if there are any questions and if I can answer. Thank you. So just briefly summarizing is the mood of how to go to a holy dham. It's being narrated, and how to offer obeisances and how to respect everybody around us other than, you know, apart from Krishna, also respecting everybody, and how to take shelter of his Krishna lotus feet. And yes, and the Vipralamba Bhav that the gopis have been experiencing when Krishna is leaving to Mathura. And one point I forgot to mention is, many times everybody might misunderstand us. Like now Akrura is there. We might think, oh, he's coming from Kamsa, it's very demoniac. But everybody might misunderstand us, but Krishna never misunderstands us. Krishna always understands us very properly. He's the only one who can, every whole world might say one thing and he can totally understand us. Like now Akrura, he knows what Akrura is, though he's coming from a demoniac family, in the same way like Ramayan, it happens with Vibhishan. And the gopis also sometimes, I myself have asked, actually gopis are saying Akrura is Krura, so is it not an offense? And then I got an answer that it is not an offense, is like when you purposefully want to defame somebody, you just keep saying again and again, make it as a habit of doing it. But this happened in a pain. So they said, this is not an offense. It came out of love on towards Krishna. So just wanted to mention these two points. Thank you so much for listening patiently.
Hi. Thank you. Thank you so much, Padma Sakhi Mataji, for this beautiful narration of Akrura visiting Vrindavan and then taking Krishna and Balram from Vrindavan. This, you know, when I came to know about this topic, you know, I was thinking that, you know, it's such a, you know, heart-breaking topic that Padma Sakhi Mataji chose, but you did it so wonderfully, Mataji. You really, you know, brought up the real mood of Akrura. Like we say that, you know, he is the epitome of vandanam, of paying obeisances. So, yeah, thank you, Mataji. Thank you for this very, very beautiful class and so many points you brought up. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Please accept my humble obeisances. Mataji, I have, first of all, it's beautiful, beautiful class, but I want to know, did you find your bead bag, Mataji?
No, Mataji, I didn't find, and it will be very difficult to find also. So what happened, I was crying. Today I lost, tomorrow I got another one. Maharaj chanted on that. How I got is also a very nice devotee's mercy again. In 2009, there were initiations in Columbus, and somehow two beads were remaining from what Maharaj chanted. They were not there. So Maharaj handed over to the host. While he was leaving, he said, okay, these two are remaining, so you keep them. So Mataji and Prabhuji were keeping one each. And when I said Mataji, and I was crying to her, I lost my beads, and Mataji sent the same day. So I got the beads from the 2009 initiative. Somebody left. Somebody couldn't make out, or I don't know how they were having extra. They said, never it happens. So Mataji always say, Maharaj is taking care of you since 2009, maybe, probably. That's why, you know, 2009, since that time, I was not in married also that time. I was not in Krishna consciousness. So I have those beads with me now.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Mataji, for sharing that with us. Such a beautiful class, Mataji. I mean, I was just glued, and I, you know, so beautiful. The point that you said, how Akrura was meditating before, you know, seeing Krishna. I was thinking, when we go to temple, I'm talking for myself, when I go to see Kalachanji before going, that I can also think, I mean, of course, I cannot meditate, but at least how Krishna will look today, how Radharani will look today, that is such a beautiful point. And I can keep it for some time, because I know I will forget eventually. So many things I learn and I forget, but this is something I will try to practice. And everything that you said, Mataji, is such a wonderful, wonderful class. I mean, I have no words practically, but You are such a wonderful devotee, Mataji, with that leg and then things. I mean, I could have never done, and I would have been on the floor of the hospital if I would have lost my bead bag rolling like how people roll in Ramanreti. Such a wonderful, thank you so much, Mataji, and please bless us with your association more and more. Such wonderful class, Mataji. Thank you. Koti koti dhanyavad pranam, Mataji. Hare Krishna. I just want to thank you again more and more, but I want to give people more chances, other devotees. But please, Mataji, I'll pause here. Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Padmasakhi Mataji, dhanyavad pranam, all glories to Srila Prabhupada. Thank you so much, Mataji, for such a beautiful class. Many pastimes you have shared. And also many of your own realizations. Thank you so much, Mataji. The way you took it, it was so nice, Mataji. There was no any, you know, disturbance in between. Even though you are sharing the other stories, that you tracked again to the track over there. Okay, now here Akrura has having this kind of emotion. Now we are going to the next level. So they were very nice, Mataji. Thank you so much for the sweet, sweet class. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Vinita Gandharvika Mataji.
Hi Krishna Mataji, Dhanavad Pranam, all glories to Srila Prabhupada and Guru Maharajas. Beautiful class, Mataji. I like what I like, you know, like how see there are pastimes, but when you can relate to them and when you can, you know, somewhere you can understand that whatever the mercy of the Lord is, whatever the pastime has happened, and when you can apply it to yourself, that I think that is the main essence of it. When and the way you could blend whatever happened with you, and you could understand the feeling of that separation from your bead bag, that was amazing. You know, that was like wonderful. Thank you for sharing it with us, and it was really amazing, Mataji. Very nicely structured and beautifully narrated. Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Very nicely explained the Akrura's emotions. And his actions and how he did it. It's very nice. And also about showing the Vaikuntha, and I'm sorry.
So, thank you.
Yeah.
And please give your thanks, Mataji. Today, my son is going for a COVID test, so he's at home. He keeps disturbing me in between. Sorry if I'm looking.
That's okay. That's how the kids are. He's acting exactly the way he's supposed to be. So it's okay. Yeah. So I like this, that you describe how, you know, whenever he enters the region of Vrindavan, then he sees the footprints of Krishna and then comes down from the chariot and offers prayers like this. It's very, very nice. And also that you also mentioned about the he showed them the Vaikuntha like that to Vajavasi. Something like that. I don't know.
No, Mataji, Akrura got, he got the Vajavasis, the Vajavasis got the vision of Vaikuntha planets and Goloka. Remember, we discussed this in our Parikrama class also.
Parikrama, yeah. Mm-hmm. So in Gujarati, there's one song about it, yes. That all the Vajvasi is saying, I don't want to go to Vaikuntha. We love the Gokul, and we don't want to go to Vaikuntha. We just like here the Gokul. Because Krishna is with them all the time. This is very nice. Thank you very much, Mataji. After a long time, you know, after the Braj Mandal and then Gaudit Mandal, and then now today, after that, thank you very much. Very nice class. Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna, Padmasakhi Mataji. Thank you for such a wonderful class, Mataji. I always love your Vrindavan pastimes narrations. They are so sweet. And I always feel whenever I hear from you, you're so totally into it, you know. And you have always your realization, like Sita Priti Mataji said, you know, you can always relate to it. I have nothing like that. And I think, oh my God, you know, you are so blessed, you know, you have so much mercy to have all those realizations also. And then you can relate to the pastime. So thank you for such a wonderful, wonderful narration, Mataji.
Thank you for all your praise, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Padma Sakhi Mataji, Dandavat Pranam. Mataji, first of all, please forgive me. I couldn't attend the first half of the class. But then from the time Akrura was taking them towards Akrura Ghat, that's where I was able to hear some of the other pastimes that you were narrating. So beautiful, Mataji. I heard about where you were talking about Maharaj, how Jayananda Prabhu, he had so many souls and all of that, Mataji. So many, I was just wondering how you relate so many different pastimes to one story. It's just so beautiful. And you are so quick with it that you move from one pastime to another so easily. Such a natural speaker, Mataji, you are. And you can speak so spontaneously. I don't know if any of this was prepared, but it sounds so beautiful. Very, very nice. You speak from your heart. And that's why, Mataji, you please bless us so that we can also someday learn to speak like you. It's just amazing. I love the session. Mataji, we'll go back and listen to the rest, to the recording, Mataji.
Thank you, Mataji. Though you're busy, you took some time out. Thank you for encouraging.
Hare Krishna, Padma Sakhi Mataji. Such a wonderful, wonderful class, Mataji. As usual, you does a very beautiful job. Thank you so much. We got an opportunity to listen from you once again. Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Radharani, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Padma Sakhi Mataji. What an excellent, wonderful class, Mataji. From starting to ending, the class is flowing like anything, Mataji, with a lot of examples, Vrindavan places, and you said it very, very attractively, Mataji. I cannot forget the class, Mataji. Thank you so much for this wonderful class and giving us again hope in our Krishna Katha, Mataji. Thank you so much, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Shamsi Priyama.
Hare Krishna, dear devotees. Anybody have any questions for Mataji?
Hare Krishna, Padma Sakhi Gopi, Koti Koti Danpat Pranam, Srila Prabhupada, Srila Gurudev Ki Jai, Shri Radha Gopinath Ki Jai, Jai Jai Nityananda, Jai Jai Gauranga. Mataji, you take us in a dham and so you make a video also, but maybe somehow you are not able to play. But one by one, you explain all the leela so nicely, Mataji, Gopi Svira, especially you sing Gopi Gita, Mataji, and Akrura Ghat and Yasoda Maiya and Nanda Baba's, they are, then Krishna and Balram is eating prasadam, then they make a garlands and jewelries and so nicely all the leela. There's the Lota Baba and you sing Gopi Gita is so nicely, Mataji, and that Sukadeva Goswami thing, and his father's Vyas Goswami, all the knowledge came. The pastime of Khichdi Prasadam, Krishna and Balram story, Krishna and Balram come to Nanda Baba's home, and Mataji, you explain about the Akrura Ghat, Shishi Yamuna Maharani Ghat, and Akrura and see Ananta Shesha, then Nanda Baba goes to Varun Loka, and all the Gwalas and Gopis, they take in Vaikunth Loka, and they think that our Shida, it's look like our Shidam Vrindavanda, and Darshan of Vishnu Loka to all the Gwalas, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhuji's like that fisherman story, and Krishna from Vrindavan Dham to Mathura, and the Akrur is a, Gopi said Akrur is Akrura, but we should not judge any Vaishnava because all Shishi Radha Madan Mohan, Shishi Radha Gopinath is sitting in each and every Vaishnava heart. And that story, Mataji, that your leg is fractured and you enter in Shidam Vrindavan, somehow if our desire is strong, Shrimati Shishi Radha Rani will make an atmosphere and somehow we will enter in Dham and the pain is not there. After that, the pain is coming. Mataji, from childhood, we enter in Shidam Vrindavan with Mama, Papa, but after marriage, 9 years course, Prabhuji is not allowed to go in Shiram Vrindavan Dham. And then Madhurpuri Mataji wore a sari tilak and with Bhagavatam, she came and like my style, that please give a permission to Mataji, and with two kids in a we will visit to Shiram Vrindavan Dham. We will take care of her. And 9:45, Prabhuji will give a permission, and my train is 4 o'clock, and we just pack the bag and we enter in a dham. From that time, every year 2 times Prabhuji will allow to go Shiram Vrindavan Dham, Shri Mayapur Dham, Shri Jagannath Puri Dham. So prayers, Mataji, when we pray from bottom of the heart, somehow Srimati Radharani will hear. And why I agree with you, by buying plane ticket or car ticket or train ticket, you cannot enter in a Shiram Vrindavan Dham. For that, you have to make a mood from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years, 9 years, that I want to enter in Shiram Vrindavan Dham, hearing Krishna Katha, Krishna Katha, Krishna Katha. Then we are qualified to enter in Shiram Vrindavan Dham. Hari Hari Gauranga Anant Koti Danvat Pranam to your sincere seva. Srila Prabhupada Srila Gurudev Shri Radha Gopinath Ki Jai. Thank you, Shiram Vrindavan Dham Ki Jai. So many lila you explained, Mataji. It's difficult to explain in 2 minutes. I will explain in your inbox. Hari Hari Gauranga Danvat Pranam.
Thank you for your prayers. Mataji just messaged me 1 hour before the class. She said, I am praying for you. You should tell, like that, you should tell nicely. Maybe because of your prayers only. If at all, I did a little bit nice. Thank you, Mataji.
Beta, if it possible, whenever you get time or by senior Vaishnava's permission, please send all the videos you make it for Shiram Vrindavan Dham.
Okay. Hare Krishna Mataji. Mataji, thank you. It was such a wonderful class. I have 2-3 questions, Mataji. Is it okay if you ask a question? Mataji, ask. If I can tell, I will tell. Or else if somebody else in the call can answer them. Please tell. Please
those are very neophyte questions, Mataji. I don't know whether the questions are right. Mataji, you said that the Krishna's footprints was protected by gopis. Because I always have that doubt. We say that all over Vrindavan, there is Krishna's footprints. But I always think people used to walk around in Vrindavan. So how do the footprints stay in the mud? But you said it has been protected by gopis. So can you show some light on it?
Mataji, yeah, that's what I have mentioned when I was saying also. Now, if you ask, there might be big buildings on top of Krishna's footprints. But that time when Krishna was there, because the gopis are aware of Krishna's footprint, because his footprints have a lot of different marks. Conch, barley corn, then there is elephant god. So different marks. So when the footprints fall on the mud, say there are gopis, other cowherd boys, and there is cows, everybody are walking, right? So they will see, when they see that, oh, this footprint is Krishna, so they don't spoil, they walk the other way. So the footprints are just remaining like that.
Okay, Mataji, I was asking on that time only. So they don't step on it. They preserve it. Yeah, okay. Okay.
Yeah, that's preserve his footsteps.
Okay. They don't step on. Okay, Mataji, and one more question. When you talk about Akrura, so can you shed some light on what was the relationship with Akrura to Kamsa and Krishna's family? And also, is there any like previous birth of Akrura's information?
Mataji, I myself wanted to know who was Akrura, if there is any previous life, but I couldn't get any information. But he is a maternal uncle for Krishna. Mother's side. If Keetida Sundari Mataji knows more details, or anybody else can say, but he is a maternal uncle of Krishna. That much I know, Mataji. That is the relationship.
Okay, and who was he in Gauralila, Mataji? I don't remember, actually. I don't know.
Who is Akrura? No, Gauralila. Maybe somebody else in the call. Mataji, if anybody knows who was Akrura in Gauralila, can you please tell? I don't know, Mataji. I have not thought that way also. Kaumudiki Mataji or Lalitangi Mataji, anybody knows, they can say. But sorry, Mataji, I didn't know. Usually I was thinking what questions I was prepared for if gopis did offense for Akrura, saying like he's Krura. That's why I was even mentioning before even others asked.
It's okay, Mataji. All the realizations that you gave were so nice, you know.
Who is Akrura and Gaur Leela, right?
Yes, Mataji.
Mataji, if I can check, I will let you know maybe tomorrow's call or some when we join, I will press do in the chat box. I'll ask some senior devotees and see.
Thank you, Mataji. Thank you. And one more question, Mataji. When you see about Krishna sitting on the chariot and Akrura is taking him, so can you shed some light on the mood of Krishna when all the gopis, you said about gopis?
No, Krishna was also nostalgic. He was also sad. But Mataji, two things here. Krishna, when he says, Krishna never leaves the Vrindavan, right? So apparently we see him as if he's leaving Vrindavan, but Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. He's always... So same question actually was asking, how do we understand when we say Krishna never leaves Vrindavan is, so there are two kinds of things, manifested and unmanifested. Like few things you can see, unmanifested is you can't see. So Krishna is there still, though he left, he's there in the remembrance of the gopis. He's still there in that unmanifested form. So his mode is, he's also feeling that separation, but he has to go because he has a higher purpose, right? That maturity also should be there now, Mataji. He came here for various reasons. So 10.5 years he was there. Then he has to fulfill his mission, means he has to leave. And that Vipralamba Bhav, love and separation, he wants to show us. That's what I mentioned in the beginning. When we, why we are seeing this going away, because when we go away, we are understanding how great the devotees in Vrajavasis are. Because after Krishna left, how much wonderfully they're thinking, oh, maybe today if you're not rest today, maybe if Krishna said tomorrow is going to come, if he come today and if he sees us like this. And Yashoda Maya was so sad. Yashoda Maya was thinking, oh, if I don't churn butter and if my Kana comes now, and what will I give him? So they're thinking about Krishna. So he wants to bring all that bhav so that we can relish all that pastimes and get more attracted towards him, right? So he has to behave that way. Did you understand, Mataji?
Yes, Mataji, I can understand. Thank you very much. It was a wonderful explanation.
Yeah, Mataji, yes. The other ways, all these things will not come out right now. Because of that, we know how to act. As we said, when we know about pure devotees, we can aspire. So Krishna has to bring all this for the future generations. Right? That's why when he advented, there are a lot of purposes, not just one. Many will be addressed. So to bring all that, he acts in that way.
Okay, Mataji, wonderful. And all the realizations was wonderful, Mataji. But the one point which I liked very much was you said that we all used to say that Kamsa is bad. But the point, like Akrura is thanking Kamsa for sending him. So that sometimes gives me the idea, like what if Duryodhana said when Krishna came for peace talk, if Duryodhana has not accepted the war, we might not have got Bhagavad Gita sometimes. Like I used to think like that. So in that way, we have to thank Duryodhana also for this Leela to take. But they're taking a part in Krishna Leela. So thank you very much, Mataji. It was a wonderful class and all your realizations are wonderful. And your beatbag, you lost. It was actually sad for me when I heard that. I pray that you get it back.
I keep praying even now. Somehow, miraculously, if it comes back. I don't know.
Yes, Krishna has a reason for everything. So thank you very much, Mataji.
I started valuing my beadbag much precious than before now.
Actually, it gives a thought for us also, Mataji, how much we have to value our beadbag also. So yeah, it's like a very nice lesson, Mataji. Thank you very much, Mataji, for your service. Jai Sachinandana, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. So the two questions that Lakshmi Mataji was asking. So Akrura is actually not the, he's not from the maternal side. He's from the paternal side.
Ooh.
He's the paternal uncle of Krishna. And Devaki's father is Devaka, right? So Devaka was the son of Akrura.
Okay.
That's how this relation is. And exactly, I don't know, but I just searched for... in that Gaur Ganesh Deepika, it is mentioned that Akrura was Gopinath. His name was Gopinath Simha. But I cannot recall who was Gopinath Simha in Chaitanya Leela, but it says that Akrura was Gopinath Simha in Chaitanya Leela. So that I could find. So Lakshmi Mataji, hope that's helpful.
Yes, so Mataji. But Mataji, Yes, sorry, Mataji, but in our Chaitanya Charitamrita,
this verse, the 38th branch of the tree was a faithful servant of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Lord jokingly addressed him as a Krura, as per Gaur Ganesh Dutipika.
Yeah, Mataji, which Leela is Madhya Leela or Antya Leela? Mataji, can you know the verse?
It's Adi Leela 10.76.
Oh, thank you very much, Mataji. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
And one more thing, Padma Sakhi Mataji, you know, while you were speaking, I was also thinking on the same thing, that how, though Akrura was such a devotee of Krishna and, you know, was also relative to Krishna, but if somebody does any Vaishnava Aparad, it is never, never, ever forgiven. So Akrura also did this Aparad, right, when he was taking Krishna and Balram from Vrindavan. He didn't even console the gopis. He didn't even bother that the gopis were terribly, you know, miserably, they were crying for Krishna and Balram. So because that offense that he committed, he was the part of the conspiracy of that Samantaka jewel. So yeah, he was being blamed, and how he was, he himself became the part of that whole conspiracy of Samantaka jewel. So there, you know, Jiva Goswami in his Laghu Vaishnava Toshni mentions that, you know, offense towards Vaishnavas will yield results, if not today, maybe tomorrow. So we have to be really, really very, very careful. Yeah, but thank you, Mataji. Thank you for your beautiful class. Hare Krishna. And thank you, Vinita Gandharvika Mataji, for sharing that, you know, the words from Chaitanya Leela.
Hare Krishna, dear devotees. So anybody would like to share their realizations regarding today's class, or anybody have any questions for Mataji? So if there are no more questions or no more realizations for Mataji, so then we can all end class with Mataji's permission and all the devotees' permission.
Just a second. Mataji, you said, you mentioned you will show one picture, right? Can you please show it?
Mataji, can I, where is that calendar, Mataji? It's not ready. Where did I keep? I can show maybe tomorrow when I join. Can I show? If somebody reminds me, I will keep it ready.
Sure.
It's there in Farmington Hills calendar for of this year. I don't know where I kept it, Mataji. I will show it. Tomorrow I'll show it.
Sure, Mataji. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Class was really very wonderful, Mataji. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay, Mataji. So then we can end the call. Once again, thank you so much, Padma Sakhi Mataji. Vancha kalpatarupyasya kripa sindhu vyaye vacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namo ananta koti vaishnavrinda ki jai namacharya pila haridas thakur ki jai shila prabhupad ki jai janmashtami special krishna katha mela ki jai har grace padma sakhi mata ji ki jai. Thank you so much, mata ji.
Thank you,
mata ji.
Thank you, mata ji, for such a beautiful class. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody, for joining.